Hey, good morning, guys. Josiah here at Easy. Just going to do a short video on how to create and manage watch lists in Thinkorswim. And so I'm doing a series on these kind of beginner type of questions that I get in email all the time so that hopefully I can help some of the newer traders out there and anyone that that has questions about this type of thing in the future. So in Thinkorswim, there's basically two places where you can manage a watch list. You've got your MarketWatch tab with the quotes sub tab. And in that window, you'll find that you can load any list of symbols here, either personal watch lists here that you have saved or named. You can load a scan here and it will show you the results of that scan as of the current moment. You can load any of the public included, you know, built-in lists that come with Thinkorswim down here in this public section. So here you might have the Russell 1000, 2000, the NYSE index, the NASDAQ 100, it has the S&P 500 and so forth. So all of those, you know, popular indexes and exchange lists and so forth are all down here. You've got your, you know, other watch lists that come with Thinkorswim. You've got your industry groups and so forth. So you can choose any of those and kind of zoom into a specific sector or industry. So once you, now you can also create a watch list here. So you just click the title here and actually, I'm sorry, in MarketWatch, you come over here and click create watch list in this small menu over here. You can also create a scan query from here, and that will allow you to add some scan criteria, and then it will pull the results up in here. Whatever watch list you already have loaded here, you can also import new symbols to that or import and overwrite, kind of replace the symbols that are already there. Or you can just pull up the edit and, you know, manually go through and change what symbols are in here. You can click add symbol, you know, remove symbols. Import new symbols, and that will allow you to paste some from the clipboard or import them from a CSV file, comma separated values file. And then you can choose whether to replace the current symbols altogether or add to them, add some additional symbols by appending to the end of that current list. And you can reorder the list by moving up or moving down here. And of course, this is where you would also name the list. So keep that in mind when you go into the edit menu, that's where you change the name that shows up here in the menu. Now you can do all of these things. So this is from the MarketWatch quotes window. You can do all of these things basically from the sidebar watch list widget as well. So you can see here, I have a watch list widget, and to get to those, you just go to the plus symbol down here and click watch list. And that will add a new watch list widget to your sidebar over here. But to manage a watch list from this sidebar, you just click the name here, and down here you've got the same type of options here. You can choose which watch list is showing in the widget. You can create a new watch list here. You can create a scan query that will bring the scanned results into the watch list in a dynamic, you know, updating form instead of a static just list that you type in. Then you can import new symbols to the existing watch list, and you can edit the watch list that you've already got loaded there. You can also share the watch list if you desire to do that, if you want to share it to another computer or share it to a friend that you have or something like that. So those are ways that you can adjust this. So I wanted to just walk you through some simple steps here. We'll create a new watch list. We'll give it a simple name, something that'll show up on the top of my alphabetical list here, hopefully. And we'll add a couple of symbols to it. So just as an example of how you would do this. So I'll just add two symbols, click save. And so you can see now I've got this new watch list named some random characters here. And I've got two symbols added to it. Now, what if I had a list that I found on the internet somewhere and I wanted to import that list? So I've got a list here loaded in Google Sheets of low float stocks. And so if I wanted to make a watch list out of just those symbols, then I can select this column here and just actually copy that whole column of symbols. And so there, now, right now, I have a whole list of text in my clipboard waiting to be pasted somewhere. So I can go in here and click Edit this watch list, and then I can click Import. And so now I can paste symbols from clipboard. And you'll see here, found these symbols here. It says it found one symbol, but it'll actually append all of those symbols to this list. So you can see kind of a preview of what it's going to import here. And of course, you can also just go to the menu here and click Import, and it takes you straight to that import menu where you can click Paste. I want to replace the current symbols that are here with the ones that I'm importing. And so now you see I've just imported that whole list of stocks. You can additionally, so like if I wanted to save this sheet as a CSV, I can do that. I'm going to export it as a CSV file here. Before I do that, let me just actually start a new sheet here. New spreadsheet. And we'll just import that this blank or this new sheet from a file, so you can see how that's done as well. Let's call this test. And now I'm going to download this as a comma separated values file, CSV file. I'm going to save it. And so once I've done that, I'm going to go over here and click Import again, and I'm going to, instead of pasting from the clipboard, I'm going to choose File, and I'm going to go to my desktop, which is where I think it downloaded it to. Let's see here. See if I can find it anywhere here. Test2sheet.csv, so that's the one we'll import. And so now it's found these symbols, and we're going to basically overwrite the, or we're going to append it. And now you'll notice that it didn't really change this, but to show you, let me just go in here into the edit menu and delete a couple of these so you can see that there is a change that's actually happening here. All right, so I'll save that. So this is slightly shorter now, so I'm going to import from that file again. And I'll replace the current symbols. And so you can see it just got longer again, and it overwrote the existing list and added those two missing symbols back to the list. So that's how you would import from a file using a CSV file. You can do it from Google Sheets. You can do it from Microsoft Excel. You know, probably pretty much any system that you use, you know, Apple numbers, you just export it as a CSV file and so forth. Or you can just make use of that copy and paste like I showed you, where you select the column of text. You can even do this from just a normal text file. If you open a text document, paste in a bunch of symbols, select them and copy them here and do the same thing, import from the clipboard, paste symbols from clipboard, it would do the exact same thing. So lots of different ways to import it from text or from a CSV file and so forth. So that's how you create a new list from some custom symbols, list of symbols that you have, maybe from the internet or somewhere else, you know, a watch list that maybe a trading guru that you follow keeps or maintains. And you can also share these lists with other people by going in here and clicking Share. So that's how you manage and create new watch lists in Thinkorswim. I did want to mention real quick that you can point any scan to that custom list that you've just created. So you can see here, there's a, in each stock hacker scan or option hacker scan, there is a scan in selection. And you can go in here and choose what list of symbols it's actually scanning in. So you can choose to scan in listed stocks, OTC stocks, NYSE stocks, and so forth. Any of these lists in here, you can actually scan within another scan, the results of that scan. Or you can scan in this new list that you've just created here. So you can see here, I just created this watch list, and I can scan only in that list of symbols for any type of setup that I want. So that's another useful way of kind of slicing and dicing the universe of symbols out there, and you know, creating a sub list of symbols that you like, and then scanning for setups against that list of stocks and so forth. So lots of different things that you can do. Thinkorswim is pretty powerful as far as that goes, so I really like it for that. Once you have your watch list set up as you need it, then you can add whatever columns to that watch list that you want. You can see here I don't have very many columns added to my market watch list here, but if you right-click the names of the columns here, you can choose Customize and go in here and add any of the built-in columns that are here or any custom columns that you create or import into your platform. And you would just basically double-click to activate to add them over here, and then you would click OK, and it would add all of those columns to your list over here. So that's how that works. So hopefully this has been helpful, especially to some of you Thinkorswim beginners out there. If you have any questions for me, check us out at easycaters.com. You can contact me there anytime. And I hope this helps, and I will talk to you next time. Thanks.